another way to look at this is to look at where the changes occurred. So if we look at a topology like this one, and we map the mutations on the lineages, and we separate the red and blue dots, and the blue and red dots are the internal and external different, like mutations. When we say internal, it's the one, the independent lineage from a single node, so to these two, and also this one. But the internal one is the one in between two nodes. So the external one is the one from one node to like the present time. But the internal one is between the two nodes, between any two nodes. So that's the differences between the blue mutations and the red mutations on this slide. So we want to look at the mutations in the external branch and the internal branch and compare the two type of mutations. And the same thing as the segregating site. So actually we use the estimates based on the segregating site estimates. But now we separate all the segregating site into the two categories, into the external one and the internal one. So that's the two estimates. And the idea is the external expectation of the external branch will approximately equal to theta for all the external branches. But the internal ones, will have a relationship with the true theta times a minus 1. A is the same estimate as the segregating size. So that's the comparison. And based on the separation of the external and the internal differences, Fu and Li derive another statistical test called Fu and Li's D-test. And the D-test is showing here. They compare the differences between the external and the internal branches. And actually, we use the overall estimates compared with the external mutations. And a very similar one is to use the theta pi. So remember, the previous one is like a theta w, right? Then you can also, because theta pi and theta w also estimates the population polymorphism. So another test they derive, they call it F test, is the one using theta pi in the formula. So it's all the D statistics. So the differences between the two estimates divided by their variance, the components of their variance. But they compare different parts of the different type of the estimates. So that's the basic idea of Fu and Li's D-test. So when you use DNASP to look at the population polymorphism data, all these tests are available in the computer program. Okay, so the rationale I already mentioned during my talk is to look at specifically all the external branches. So all these new mutations, so all the branches are external, are all the mutations, they are very, very new. Then you use that to compare to the pi and theta. And you can think a little bit about like how the new mutations or the low frequency data contribute to theta pi and theta w. And that was something I want you to look into by yourself.